The death toll in Gaza has risen on day four of Operation Protective Edge after Israel's sustained aerial bombardment of the Strip. It now stands at 98. A fifth of that toll, of those numbers, are children. We have seen various intercepts and various rockets coming out of Gaza as we've been standing here already this morning. The intercepts have happened as well over Tel Aviv. The mayor of Rishat LeZion, just south of Tel Aviv, telling people to stay in shelter for 10 minutes, even after an intercept, because that's how long it can take for the shrapnel still to come down. Ben Gurion Airport near Tel Aviv closing for the first time since this operation began, just for 10 minutes, but apparently precisely because of just such an intercept. And in the north of Israel, also a worrying new development for Israeli authorities, a rocket coming in from Lebanon. Lebanese authorities saying that they have neutralized two rockets that were positioned in southern Lebanon and also confiscated military equipment from there. President Obama has called Israel's President Benjamin Netanyahu and offered to try and help facilitate some kind of ceasefire along the lines of November 2012 to try and bring in other regional power brokers to help in that, namely Egypt, Qatar, possibly Turkey. But the Egypt that brokered last time ceasefire is a very different Egypt from now. Then it was the Muslim Brotherhood who shared close ties with Hamas. Now it is a different story. The question whether Benjamin Netanyahu will send in ground troops, 30,000 have already been called up, and it still is a possibility, say Israeli officials. Diana Magne, CNN, near Ashkelon, Israel.